Hi everyone. So in this video we are going to talk about use state with objects. Okay, we have already seen that how to do with a boolean, like if I'm returning true. Before that I can show you the demo, I mean how it was working. Plus plus, reset, minus minus for the previous video. Okay, coming back to our video, in this we are going to talk about how we can use state as an object. I mean how we can put objects in an state. Currently we were talking about number, boolean, but it can have an object also, something like this. This is now an object. So count will be treated as an object and set count will be putting some object properties inside it. Okay, so what we can do is, let's say I have a user. I will be writing simple form for this user and set user. Okay, and what this empty object can have, okay, like I have a name which is initialized with empty, so I have two properties. Right, now if in this JSX if I try to print user.name, it will give us the empty value, user.email will give us the empty value. So this is how we are accessing the state properties, right? Set user we were not writing, we can just write a div and we can set some properties, like if I do div and on click of that div, what we are doing is we are calling some method. So I just put the closings so we don't see any error. Here on the on click, what we can do is set user, we can just directly call. Here also you can use the same thing. Here I'm calling set user and we'll be putting one object properties. So I can have a name, email, which is some property. Something like this, right? This is how it happens. But what I want is, I will be writing simple HTML form and will setting these values from the on change event of text fields. Okay. So we can write simple form, we can wrap it around simple form, and we can have two text fields. Okay, and those text field will have a on change event. So input type text, there I will capture the username, value will be, now value will be user.name, because user is the state and name is that property which we wanted to access, and placeholder and all you can create. So this is my user and this is for my email. Input type email will be here, value, and what other things we have to specify is on change event. So on the on change, what we are going to do is we will be calling one method and we will be updating the value. Here we will be updating the name, here we will be updating the email property. And how we are going to do it? We can just call a one particular method, like onChange will have an event object. E.target.value will give me what you are typing in this text field. And what I can do is, here I can call this setUser method and I can pass, I can update the property. I can update the individual property. So, I mean, if you are updating the name or if you are updating the email, then final state is actually the merge of it. So name and email will always have the value whatever user has been entered. So I am setting name, which is e.target.value. Same thing I can write here for the email, set user, and this is the email property for the input type email. And here I can also try to print both the values, user.name, user.email. Okay, this is simple. Now from the, whenever you're typing something, we are doing on change event and we are calling set user. Either you can call, you can write a simple function here, const update user, and based on the event we are getting, we can either update a first name, either update a name, or either update an email. Okay, but then in that case you have to keep some property name and all, and you have to identify that which particular function, which particular text field is being handled here. Either you created two different functions, update name, update email, that is fine. If you are writing common, then you have to check from which event it is coming from, either name or email. Okay, we'll simplify this method. In single two line, we can write a common function using key value, because what we have is key and value, and the same properties we will have in the event object, so that we can manage. That I will talk in the last few sessions, how we can actually use the hooks at the advanced level. But here we are able to simplify this, and we can write these functions at the same line on change, updating the object. So my objective of this video is that use state can manage the objects, right, name and email, and we are able to update them like this. Okay, now this is simple use state. Here it can have a boolean values also. Boolean values will be like if form is submitted or not. If you wanted to check, here we used to have on submit method, on submit equal to handle submit method, and this we can define here const handle submit. And what we are doing in the handle submit is we are just toggling one property and sending this data to some API. Const submitted true false, boolean values, you can have a submitted, it submitted, something like this. That should also be fine. Set submitted and use state equal to false. Initially submitted will be false, but when you click on it, first what you will do is set submitted. First we will check the validation. I mean, you can do it. So if user.email, user.name and user.email both has values, obviously we are going to submit in this particular case only. So set submitted will be true, otherwise do nothing. Return from here. Before that, we can just stop the propagation and all. E.stopPropagation, E.prevent default, you can write here. Okay, here we are just checking set submitted true and false, and based on that you can actually show the error messages. If username is not there, email is not there, you can actually have one message property also here. So we are covering a lot of things here, right? Message which is initially empty, set message, or you can say validation, set validation. If email and this are null, right, it will be true only if you have entered a name and email. Otherwise, you are trying to click the submit method. Here we need to have input type submit. Or a button type submit or something like that. Okay, children, button. We can just simply create a button. Button submit and button type. And we can on click of this. We can do the form submit. I mean, there are different ways, handle submit we can do here. Okay, set submit, and based on the user email. Here, once you click on to this handle submit, we are actually checking name and email, set submitted true, otherwise false. And otherwise, what we can do is set message. Please enter some values, something like this. And you can print the message here. If you try to see what the error is, you can see this is coming up. Please enter values. If I'm typing something like this, okay, it should be email. Okay, fine. So this is how it is working. I mean, not a right form. It is updating email, it is updating name. So we are actually printing user.name and user.email. Okay, user.name and user.email. So it is actually updating the common values, I think. So name and email we have. Set user. So what we can do is, here is a trick. So it is actually trying to update the whole object and putting the name only there. You see this, if I'm putting 1 and 2, I can see only 2 value, right? If I just put 3, if I just put 12 here, then it is overriding, because in set user we are overriding the whole object. So what we can do to fix this is, we already have a user object, right? And what we are adding, we are just updating the name property. We already have a user object and we are updating the email property here, right? So this should fix our problem. Right now we are getting both the values, 11 22, okay, 2221. This is fine. So you need to take care of this. In set user, this is the existing object. When you, whatever you are writing in set user means you are overriding the whole object. So in that case, you pass the existing object, this is a spread operator, and we are just updating the name property from here. So it's not like set state we used to do earlier. This is the existing user object and we are updating the email property here. Okay, that's it. Thanks everyone.